the sky, we can get some amazing sunsets and amazing sunrises. Leading up to it being here yesterday, you know where this thing is going. This dry and dusty layer of air aloft is going to find itself over the southern United States and lead to some of those spectacular sunsets and sunrises and a milky, hazy appearance aloft that would likely be late in the week or in the next weekend.
Dr. Rick Postel, thanks for that. Now, we do want to track this dust from the African coast by more than 2,000 miles to the west through the Atlantic and into the Gulf of Mexico, perhaps clipping portions of the lower Keys and Florida. But look at the flow of moisture that streams into Texas, Louisiana, and Arkansas. As Dr. Postel mentioned, it may be a few days before we see the implications of that dust in terms of beautiful sunrises and sunsets, but also poor air quality. What else are we watching through the tropics? We're watching several different disturbances or waves. Here we've got Invest 92E in the Pacific, also Invest 95L in the Atlantic, along with two other areas to watch in the Pacific. So let's head to the Pacific Ocean, just to the west of Mexico. Invest 92E has a 60% chance of developing in the next 5 days. It's moving to the west at about 15 or 16 miles per hour. If we do see any sort of development, this is likely where it is to develop well into the water here. So certainly some good news. Another area to watch, though, with a 60% chance of developing. This is just to the east of Hawaii here. 5-day development zone is right there. Still well over open waters, which is where we like to see it. Now let's move a tad bit closer to home here. Invest 95L just off the coast by about 300 miles to the south and east of Cape Cod. 35-mile-an-hour winds with this thing. It's moving to the east at about 6 miles per hour. A 40% chance of developing into some sort of tropical or subtropical or tropical depression here in the next 2 to 5 days' time. It does look like any sort of development, though, would be short-lived. But what we do have to look at, especially for late June, we've got to look a little bit closer to home here through the Caribbean and the Atlantic and also the Gulf of Mexico. Outside of that, we open up the playing field a bit more to cover the Gulf, to cover the Atlantic and the NBR as well. So all signs are saying yes, tropical season is certainly cranking and chugging right along. We'll be right back.
Jake from State Farm.
Kathy's like a good neighbor. State Farm.